I'm the government actuary. I'm the head of the actuarial profession in government. Most actuaries in governments are in the government actuary department, which I lead. I'm also a member of the analysis function board. My typical day reflects my dual responsibilities of professional and departmental leadership. Professionally, this involves consideration of the advice that we are providing our government clients. In some cases, working and delivering that advice myself. In other cases, it's offering input and guidance to colleagues. This requires me to keep in touch with our various domains of professional interest, including the wider analysis function. Ensuring our perspectives are appropriate and relevant to the environment in which we work. Departmental management involves working on our strategy, our plans and our performance, working with our board and executive to ensure that we're on track, fulfilling our mission and demonstrating our value and our values. My career has involved both private and public sectors. I trained as an actuary within the insurance world, having studied mathematics at university. I had a number of technical, managerial and executive roles in a major insurance business before I switched into the public sector 15 years ago. In retrospect, my journey has been quite serendipitous with new and different challenges. It's also been one of lifelong learning, though I can't claim to be a very real expert at anything. Actuaries are highly trained experts at quantifying risk, especially those in financial environments such as investment, pensions and insurance. We're able to advise policy professionals on the financial implications of policy options, especially where there are risks and uncertainties. And we work on some very large government liabilities, both actual liabilities and contingent ones. And all our actuarial work conforms to the very highest professional standards. The COVID effects on much of our advice, and actuaries have had to be up to speed with the latest developments, especially in mortality, for example, where we've contributed to SAGE papers. Actuaries have been involved in several government responses to the crisis too, such as the underpins to business interruption insurance and the film and TV insurance markets. We've helped some of our clients, such as NHS Resolution, with new schemes to cover COVID risks. And many of our actuaries answered the analysis function call out for secondments to support multiple initiatives within different departments. More generally, we've had to adjust to the increased pace of the crisis, the extra demands on our resources, and of course, remote working. Well, the starting position is a training programme with an actuarial employer. At GAD, we take on a number of graduates each year to begin the professional training, which combines on-the-job experience, professional development, and a series of examinations. Experience during training with us is broadly based, reflecting the range of work government actuaries actually do. Thereafter, it's all about developing skills and experience as a client advisor, an expert analyst, a specialist in a particular domain, or a versatile generalist. Increasingly, our actuaries are working alongside other analysts, and often that's the best way for our government clients to use us and maximise the impact of our specialist skills. Through the analysis function, actuaries can broaden their network of government contacts, contribute to better understanding of the government's overall capacity and capability of its functions. My downtime is usually relaxing socially, enjoying music, art and reading, some light exercise and some gardening. Chasing the sunshine, especially around the Mediterranean, but that's becoming a distant memory during the pandemic, of course. But our holiday home in Cornwall came into its own. And to prove that you can take the boy out of Salford, but not Salford out of the boy, I do still maintain a strong interest in the fortunes of Manchester United and Lancashire County cricket teams that I supported as a young boy.